Real people. Real crimes. Real life drama.
I fear for my life and my safety every minute of every single day. My name is Polly Perret. I am an actress. I have been stalked for over a decade, and I'm actively working to change stalking law in America. When you're being stalked, it's not just a nuisance, it's terrifying. And there are people dying.
Christina Grimmie had no idea who Kevin Lobel was or that he was stalking her. On June 10th of 2016, he tracked her to her performance at the Plaza Theater in Orlando, Florida.
You guys are awesome!
Active shooter, we have one down.
He was within arm's length of her when he fired his first shot.
Christina got shot, Christina Grimmie.
He shot her in the head.
No pulse.
No pulse?
No pulse.
She was pronounced deceased at Orlando Regional Medical Center.
After Christina Grimmie was murdered, it really hit home for me that could be my reality.
And this is basically the problem.
I'm Lenora Claire. In the past 5 years, I've had a relentless stalker.
And then what I was saying, Lenora,
has been completely obsessed with terrorizing me every day of my life.
I explained to them that, like, do you want to talk to me?
Prior to me, Justin Mouser already had history. He was arrested and institutionalized for stalking Ivanka Trump.
For months. Mostly electronically.
They might have legitimate justifications for saying you can't go for, like, a girl like Ivanka Trump because it makes too many guys jealous.
My name is Justin Masler, but also my angelic name is Cloud Star Chaser.
My day literally starts off going, well, where is he?
I'm, like, homeless in San Francisco. My hotel's in, like, New York City.
If he's in California, then I'm in a real panic. If he's in another state, okay, I can breathe for the day.
This was one of those panic days. Justin sent Lenora a video, and she recognized the background. He was here in L.A.
Hey, guys, so check it out. This is the real Harry Potter. I'm at Universal Studios.
I just kept thinking to myself, oh, my God, is today the day?
The man just wouldn't stop.
Is this the day that everything just gets taken from me?
So we set off to find the stalker. He knows we're going to call him.
I'm ready. Everybody ready?
Justin, are you a stalker?
My biggest fear is that he finds me.
Try
stopping
me!
Should Lenora be afraid?
From what I've seen of Justin Masler, Lenora should be afraid.
I will not stop sending emails to Lenora Claire!
I don't think my son is a physical danger to anybody.
To be my friend, you have to have intellectual strength, which is the...
He lives in his mind.
So I just programmed my spaceship.
He believes that this world is in trouble, and he wants to save it.
I could defeat them because I'm Superman.
At no time did I ever think that I'd be at the center of a national manhunt for Justin.
Look, you people need to learn that I don't have a lot of respect for fear.
I believe he's a ticking time bomb.
And I don't have a lot of respect for, like, oh, we're afraid.
I think it's just a matter of time before something very bad happens with him.
Justin, calm down.
Jesus Christ, try and go against me. Watch what happens.
I'm Erin Moriarty. Tonight on 48 Hours. Stalked.
We'll be back in 90 seconds.
So I'll take a little moment to say I really, really miss you. I'll be really...
It has been over 8 months since friends and fans across the country lost singing sensation Christina Grimmie. A rising star shot dead by a stalker after finishing a concert in Orlando. What do you miss about Christina?
I just miss the fact that I had a partner in faith doing the same thing.
Tyler Ward not only lost a friend and a fellow musician, he lost a church buddy.
Someone I could look over and say, she's doing it right. She's not in it for the wrong reasons.
Is it so hard to believe that she's gone?
Yeah. Yeah. Every day. I think about her every day.
Bria Kelly remembers a lot of things about her best friend and fellow contestant from The Voice. Christina's knockout performance. Those charming YouTube videos. But mostly, she remembers the little moments they shared together.
I miss her being a phone call or a text away.
I'm about to scare Bria.
Every moment now is just, like, so, like, precious to me that we have together.
Yes, this life is worth
it. It doesn't get any easier. And it won't get any easier for quite a long time.
Christina Grimmie's murder is a cold reminder that stalking is a deadly problem, says actress Polly Perrette, star of the CBS show NCIS.
People are getting killed and hurt, and everything leading up to that feels like a death every single day anyways when you're a victim.
Polly knows that terror all too well. Although her tormentor has never explicitly threatened her life, she lives in fear that his harassment will escalate.
The nightmare is you don't know what the end game is. Are you going to just be harassed for the rest of your life? Is the door going to open 5 minutes from now and that's the end of your life? Everything in life is terrifying when you're a stalking victim.
Polly doesn't want to mention the name of the man she says stalks her or go into detail, but she says he has cast a dark shadow over every aspect of her life.
Every day I'm afraid to check my email. Every day I'm afraid to look on the internet. Every day I'm afraid to leave my house. So many of us victims, we become recluses. We get afraid of everything, and the fear doesn't subside. It gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and your world gets smaller and smaller and smaller.
With an estimated 7.5 million Americans stalked a year, and that's only the reported cases, the time has come, says Polly, to fight back.
I've never spoken publicly about my situation. Speaking about it publicly, I am afraid, will put me in danger, but I'm already in danger. But we need to get these laws changed to try to help other people. What are they waiting for? They're waiting for one of us to get killed?
Polly is leading the charge, working with California Congressman Adam Schiff to raise public awareness and create new laws to make it easier to arrest and prosecute stalkers.
Stalking laws do not work right now. They have not been updated in 20 years. In that 20 years, so much has happened, mainly the internet. Stalkers, that's their greatest tool. They can use the internet to stalk their victims.
While most victims are stalked by former lovers, some become targets simply for crossing paths with an obsessive, mentally unstable person. This is the case with Lenora Claire. She's been stalked for over 5 years by a man she met only once.
For me, being stalked is similar to having your head held underwater. You can't breathe. You can't scream, because no one's gonna hear you. And you're just waiting for it to be over.
This is the man Lenora says is drowning her.
For people who don't know who I am, I'm Justin Master. I'm what they call like the chosen one.
34-year-old Justin Master, a diagnosed schizophrenic. He legally changed his name to Cloud Star Chaser.
My real name is Cloud Star Chaser.
He keeps a list of over 100 possible targets, including business tycoons like Jacob Rothschild and Rupert Murdoch. He also obsesses over celebrities like Ivanka Trump.
Oh, if you guys are wondering, the whole thing with like Ivanka Trump
and lesser known people like Lenora Claire.
Lenora is not like want me to stop contact her.
Every facet of my life is influenced by this person.
It all started in 2011 with this LA Weekly article featuring an art show she was curating. The idea was to photograph the most interesting guests and hang their pictures in the exhibit.
All kinds of people came, like literally, it was fabulous. It was a really diverse group.
Into the studio walked Justin Masler in an outfit sure to earn him a spot on the gallery wall, a spacesuit.
He came to the gallery wearing a spacesuit?
That's correct. At first I just thought it was just sort of like a funny character. I didn't really think anything of it.
But then his tone changed.
And then he told me, like looking very intensely into my eyes, oh, you look like Jessica Rabbit and Lilo from the Fifth Element. I think you're a supreme being, just like Lilo, and I'm gonna stalk you. And it just began this odyssey of almost 6 years of stalking and harassment by him.
Lenora says Massler, who sometimes thinks he's Jesus Christ.
Yo, I'm Jesus Christ. I'm a god and I have real divine powers.
Harry Potter.
Justin Massler is the real Harry Potter.
Or various superheroes.
The real Superman from Man of Steel.
Has bombarded her with ranting emails, texts, and videos.
This is the one where he says he's the real life Roger Rabbit. I'm the real life Jessica Rabbit. And the bottom, it ends with a very explicit rape story.
Some so violent, Lenora says, he has turned her life into a reality horror show.
I live in a constant fear that Justin Massler could rape me, kidnap me, kill me, gas me, go after my friends, go after my family. He's threatened my boss. He said that he would kill him if I continue to work there. Even something as simple as having a job, he's trying to take away from me.
After that threat, Lenora says she finally went to the LAPD, a stack of emails in hand.
So I thought, okay, I have all this evidence, they're going to take me seriously, and that couldn't be further from the truth. They were dismissive, they made fun of me, they suggested that I alter my appearance.
They wanted you to alter your appearance.
Yeah, they just said, well, you know, if you toned it down, maybe he would leave you alone.
Polly says there's a name for that. It's called victim shaming.
Victim shaming of stalking victims is something that, along with everything else that we have to deal with, people will say, well, you shouldn't have worn that, you shouldn't have dated them, you shouldn't have been there, you should, all kinds of things. But the truth is that we're not the criminals here.
I'm sorry, I refuse to believe that my hair color or my build or my dress, the way I carry myself in any way, that I should be victimized in this manner.
Despite her many appeals for help, Lenora says it took years before they took her warnings seriously.
The police probably look and say, look, Dustin Massler has been stalking a number of people for a number of years. He's never hurt anyone yet. Yet. I'm telling you, I think he's very dangerous. I mean, how many death threats do I need to get before it's taken seriously?
While Justin has not shown up in person to visit Lenora,
I'm not like a violent person towards women, you know what I'm saying?
He has traveled to visit other targets. To Lenora, it's just a matter of time.
It's just, will he find me?
He's already made headlines once in 2010 for pursuing this woman, Ivanka Trump. Ivanka Trump. Beautiful, rich, and very, very powerful, has something in common with Lenora Claire. She's been stalked by Justin Massler.
Ivanka Trump is my baby mama, and I have the right to email her.
It was a huge story in 2010 when Massler targeted Trump with a barrage of ominous emails and tweets, using a profile picture that appeared to show Justin covered in blood and threatening to commandeer her then-fiancé, Jared Kushner's newspaper, and to kill himself at Ivanka's jewelry store.
His mom told me that he was a very eccentric individual, highly, highly intelligent. He had some mental disorders.
Attorney George Von Balakis represented Massler when he was arrested and charged with stalking Ivanka Trump. She was granted an order of protection from him.
To this day, I don't know if he ever really grasped how his conduct could affect her.
Massler violated the restraining order, and his charges escalated from misdemeanor to felony. He missed two court dates, was caught in California, and brought back to New York. He spent 9 months in a psychiatric hospital, then pleaded guilty to stalking Trump, and was sentenced to time served.
These phony restraining orders, which are not the will of Ivanka.
Why Ivanka Trump, though?
Fame and beauty. Someone who was hungry for attention is going to latch on to someone who already has that attention and figures that he can get it from her.
Ivanka Trump is hardly alone. Many celebrities find themselves plagued by persistent stalkers. Psychologist Chris Mohandy is the former head of the LAPD's Behavioral Science Unit.
In the beginning, when we started studying celebrity cases in particular, they were often the longest ones because they're driven by delusions and mental illness.
Gwyneth Paltrow has been one of the hardest hit. In 1999, this man, Dante Soyou, started bombarding her with pornography, sex toys, and bizarre letters, saying he wanted to take God's scalpel and cut out her sin. Soyou traveled from Ohio to L.A., looking for Gwyneth at her mother, Blythe Danner's house, twice before he was finally arrested. Experts say the fact that he traveled to see her greatly escalates the risk.
The person is in the physical presence of their potential victim, and that's what you need in order for there to be violence.
In 2000, Soyou was found not guilty of stalking by reason of insanity and spent 5 years in a psychiatric hospital. But 4 years after his release, he started up again, sending Paltrow 66 letters in care of her attorneys about God and his love for her. In 2015, Soyou was arrested again and last year stood trial in L.A. for stalking. Deputy District Attorney Wendy Siegel.
What did scare her about the letters?
The obsession.
The obsession for over 17 years. That he was never going to leave her alone.
He's a gentle person. He is a very religious man.
Linda Westland defended Soyou and says her client only sent those letters because he was trying to make amends.
But Linda, you want to make amends to someone, you could send one letter, maybe two letters. More than 60 letters, that's not making amends. That's harassing somebody.
Possibly. It's possibly harassing somebody.
But you're saying it's not stalking because he didn't directly threaten her.
No, I'm saying it's not stalking because he didn't have any malicious intent.
I'm a non-dangerous type of guy.
Soyou spoke to 48 Hours about the case.
And what about the charges against him? Are you a stalker?
No, I'm not a stalker. I'm not a stalker.
The jury agreed, finding him not guilty of stalking Paltrow in 2015. It came down to one critical clause in the law, intent to cause fear. The jury did not believe that Soyou intended to cause Paltrow any fear.
You have a right to free speech in this country. You have a right to contact people. You have a right to proselytize. You can bombard somebody with letters all you want. It's a very strongly protected right.
But when does free speech cross the line and become stalking?
It's not black and white. One of the problems with the stalking laws are it's very gray. How many phone calls, how many emails, how many tweets does it take?
Could you imagine what would happen to the justice system if everybody thought, you know, well, I feel scared. I think that person's committing a crime. And the Gestapo come on and cart him away. That's not how this country works.
Strengthening the laws as advocates want could conflict with protected freedoms. But Polly Perrette says victims' rights need to be considered, too.
I always think, you know, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. It's like, I don't have any of that. This affects my life every single day.
Lenora Clara says she's also a prisoner, living in fear of Justin Masler and the knock on her front door.
Today can be the day, tomorrow can be the day, 2 years from now can be the day.
You will not stop me from sending messages!
What happened when Justin Masler jumped bail? Go to 48 Hours on Facebook.
Christians call me Jesus Christ, but Jesus Christ is actually a fictional version of me, kind of like Neo in the Matrix.
You will not stop me from sending messages!
I got a real light star right here, like you can't really see it, but
the problem was just like...
These are some of the many faces of Justin Masler. Finding the real Justin Masler is like chasing a ghost, an apparition who moves in and out of the real world, traveling from state to state. We didn't know where he gets money or how he lives. But there is one thing we did know. Wherever he goes, he leaves a trail of frightened targets in his wake.
Are you aware of a temporary restraining order against you? Yeah.
In this phone call last May, a police detective warned Justin to stay away from one of his targets, a former schoolmate who lives in San Francisco.
She wants you to leave her alone. Okay.
Within minutes, Justin went from normal.
But that's fine. I won't talk to her anymore.
To delusional.
You're not going to spread lies about me. She's not afraid of you. I'm Superman.
To angry.
Hey, officer, you don't lie about me, Jesus Christ.
And finally, to bizarre.
I am the leader of a 108-person royal family. We are going to war with any person.
Hey, Lenora, it's Class Sergeant. Listen, I asked
you. As you sit here, do you think your life is at risk?
I explained to them that, like, you actually do you want to talk to me? It's just like Jacob Rothschild's people are, like, threatening you.
Absolutely. I think my life is at risk. I know it is. Every morning in L.A., Lenora Claire checks her computer to see where he is. It's the ticking time bomb. It's hanging over my head every day. Any day he's not in California is a good day.
A lot of people ask me, since you're Jesus Christ,
this was not a good day.
And it can all be blamed on Taylor Swift.
Right now we're looking at a video that Justin sent me from the San Monica Youth Hostel.
Because the popular girls, led by Taylor Swift, are not acknowledging me.
I just said to myself, you know, is today the day? Is today the day that he actually does what he keeps telling me, what he's gonna do? I was afraid to leave my apartment.
With Justin apparently staying just 13 miles away, Lenora alerted the LAPD, but got no response until days later. He's clearly been traveling through Los Angeles. We know he posted videos from Universal Studios.
Hey guys, check it out. This is the real Harry Potter, man. Universal Studios.
The man just wouldn't stop, and no one seemed able to catch him. So we set off to find a stalker. But everywhere we looked, Justin Masler seemed to stay one step ahead. Until finally, with a little help from technology. Okay, I'm ready to launch when you guys are all ready. We were able to track Justin down through his various email accounts.
I'm ready. Everybody ready?
And we set up a FaceTime interview on his phone.
I'm going.
He answered the phone 9 a.m. sharp, just as planned.
Oh, hello?
It works.
Hey, how are you doing?
I'm really good. How are you?
Oh, I'm pretty good. Thanks.
Can you see me here?
Yeah, I can see you. Yeah, you're in, like, the TV studio?
Yeah.
Hey, cool.
What do I call you, Justin?
Oh, just Justin. That's just, like, my normal name.
And where are you right now?
I'm just in Salt Lake City.
He had left L.A., he said, in search of his friend Wonder Woman, clearly another target.
I know her, but
I asked where he was staying.
And then I just got stuck broke again, so I'm just staying at a shelter right now.
So, I mean, how do you get there?
Well, I just took a bus. I mean, like, I get, like, $600 a month on, like, SSI.
You mean Social Security Disability is what you get?
Yeah. Or, like, my mom was helping me out before.
Are you taking medication, Justin?
No, see, the thing is, like, I'm not schizophrenic because I'm actually Jesus Christ.
Justin, you weren't always like this. Well, what was your life like when you were growing up?
When I was growing up? No, I've always been like this. I don't really change. I've been,
I asked him about his past before schizophrenia. Where did you grow up?
Well, I grew up in Jersey, and then I went to the Phillips Exeter Academy for high school.
He had gone to Exeter, one of the most exclusive prep schools in the country, a breeding ground for future leaders. And now here he is, living a life of isolation, a prisoner of his own delusions.
But Justin, isn't this really lonely for you? This has to be a
very... No, because, like, okay, my species is not dependent on social interaction.
I had to ask him about stalking.
I mean, there are some people who are a little scared of you. I mean, do people have reason to be afraid of you?
Like, the only people who would have reason to be afraid of me are, like, bad people.
I asked him then specifically about Lenora Claire. Does Lenora Claire have a reason to be afraid of you?
No, she's on our main team now. I'm like, I'm not threatening her. I'll never attack Lenora Claire or, like, harm her in any way. But at the same time, you can't have, like, women like that f***ing up our social matrix.
And when I asked if he would stop sending emails to Lenora and the others he stalked, he asked, why don't you stop?
I'm Jesus Christ. People want
to
know who I am.
That question led to an explosion of anger.
I will not stop sending them because those restraining orders are illegal, and I will continue to defy this government's order.
We're just showing you a small portion of the 34-minute conversation we had with Justin last October. At this point, he seemed to lose control and threatened violence. Police records reveal that Justin Masler once assaulted a police officer, but it doesn't appear that he has ever physically harmed any of his targets.
You will not stop me from sending messages! I will destroy you!
Justin, calm down. Are you okay? I gotta see he's okay.
Hello?
Are you okay?
Yeah.
I will not
stop sending messages. And if Justin, calm down. Destroy any government court that oppose our freedom. I wasn't yelling at you, by the way. I was just letting people who think they can control me. I'm not angry at you. You're fine. But yeah, no, Lenore and Ivanka are part of my team, and Lenore is not like want me to stop contacting her.
What if I tell you she does? Stop controlling her. Will you believe me when I tell you she doesn't want you to send any more emails or posts?
No. Lenore, I know that Lenore does not mind me sending anything because she's part of my team.
As we finished the call, Justin seemed to go back inside himself.
I'm not playing around because I'm Bad Bear. No, I'm being Bad Bear.
All right, so take care.
Yeah.
All right, stay in touch with me and take care. Okay? Are you okay?
Yeah, I did. I slipped down to you.
I just lost it. And what do you do all day?
Not much now.
Talk with Justin Massler was sad, but also very frightening.
If they go against me, I will use the power of God to destroy anyone who opposes me.
He had made explicit death threats to public figures, threats we decided not to air. Because of the threats, we contacted Chris Mahondi.
I will destroy you!
What's your reaction to seeing this?
I'm more than concerned about this, Aaron. I think that what he's talking about is a very violent mental life. He identifies with the role of vigilante. He does not believe that the rules apply to him.
You think, from just seeing this, that the threat is that real?
I believe from just seeing this that the threat is that real. He needs to be dealt with. And soon.
Mohandi urged us to share the video with Detective Reed of LAPD's Threat Management Unit.
It's up to people to be real-life superheroes and take the law into their own hands.
It's very clear that it appears to be a mental health component.
I will not stop sending emails to Lenore Claire!
He seems to be very violent in nature.
Reed, too, was worried that Justin might do something violent. But Justin's mother, Randy Massler, disagrees.
I don't think my son is a physical danger to anybody.
Randy understands how scary that FaceTime video appears, but says that the outburst was more of a release for Justin than a real threat.
I'm sure that as soon as he was done with that rant, he was back to however he had been before. It's a release.
I wasn't yelling at you, by the way.
I know.
People who think they can control me, I'm not angry at you, you're fine.
This is a disease. His brain is not functioning. You can't expect rational thoughts from an irrational mind.
But then Batman vs. Superman, I'm Superman.
And people don't.
It wasn't always this way, says Randy. What comes to mind when you think about Justin's childhood here?
Happy.
The Justin of today is not the boy she raised in this upscale New Jersey house.
You had all the hopes for him.
Yes.
Like every parent.
Yes.
But I would justify it at the time because he really was that smart.
Randy describes her son socially as quirky. He would sometimes act out. The student once groomed for the Ivy League, who achieved a nearly perfect score on his SATs, became a high school dropout. Next was a stint in the Navy. Randy thought the military could be just what Justin needed. It wasn't.
We got a call that he had a psychotic break, and he was going to kill himself.
Justin was hospitalized and in and out of psychiatric wards for much of his 20s. Diagnosed with schizophrenia, his mother helplessly watched the son she loved withdraw further.
And what's it like for you emotionally to be going through the ups and downs with Justin? It's been so long that if I allowed myself to fall apart every time he got in trouble, I wouldn't be here. You get used to it, I guess. And Justin has just suffered. And the child that I raised is gone. That child is gone.
Randy still wants to help Justin and sometimes gives him money.
Oh, my hotel is in, New York City, so I don't know.
Wouldn't it be better to don't give him money if he didn't have money so he couldn't travel the way he does? I mean, aren't you in some ways enabling what he does? Maybe. I never thought about it that way. I thought I was helping him to live a little bit, but I didn't know that he was traveling in the country scaring women.
Brandy says she didn't know about Lenora Claire. She feels her son is desperate to connect with people, even if it is just over a computer.
Yeah, I use computers everywhere. It's really easy to get like wireless in or computer access these days.
Do you think Justin is lonely?
Oh, yes. He tries reaching out to anybody.
The emails are not hurting anyone.
Do you think he's contacting these women to scare them or to have contact with them?
I think he's contacting these women to have contact with them. But when they aren't interested, he gets mad.
That's not so! You will not stop me!
He's a very unstable person. And his instability can rapidly turn violent.
Most people who have serious mental illness will not be dangerous to others, and that's an important point. So you're looking at the unique variables in a particular case that may relate to increased violence risk. From what I've seen of Justin Masler, he has had violent ideas, he's pursued many other victims, he is not dissuaded by restraining orders, and all of those are concerning risk factors.
With those concerns, a search for Justin Masler was now underway. In the FaceTime interview, Justin had told me he was in Utah.
In Salt Lake City.
So Detective Reed got in touch with the Salt Lake City police.
They actually located Mr. Masler. They determined at that time that he needed to be evaluated for a mental evaluation.
Justin was involuntarily committed to a Utah psychiatric hospital. Typically, this is allowed by law when authorities feel a mentally ill person is a threat to himself or to others.
I don't have a lot of respect for fear.
After about 2 months, Justin agreed to go to another facility in Nevada near his mother.
So when I got the call that he was detained in Utah, I was so excited. I got to live what I call a normal life, and it was glorious. It was so nice.
But shortly after arriving at the Nevada facility, Justin disappeared.
Police say this man, Justin Masler, was taken into the Northern Nevada Adult Mental Health Facility. He then took off on foot.
With Justin on the move and now missing, Lenora was shaken.
I was just frozen with fear, and I went inside and I locked my door. Anything's possible with this man.
Police are searching for a missing endangered adult, Justin Masler. If you see him, you're asked to notify police right away.
Justin Masler had disappeared many times before, but this time was different. He was on law enforcement's radar now because the woman he admitted stalking in 2011 was no longer just a private citizen. She was the daughter of the president-elect of the United States.
You can't go for, like, a girl like Ivanka Trump because it makes too many guys jealous.
With Justin missing in action, the Secret Service paid his mom in Nevada a visit. It wasn't the first time, she says, law enforcement came calling.
I just try to cooperate and do what I can.
Randy gave them the phone number of her other son, who led them clear across the country to the missing Justin Masler. Justin had flown here to New York to see his brother Jeremy, who booked him into this hotel. It was a mere coincidence, their mother said, that the hotel was just 2 blocks from Trump Tower. When Secret Service agents arrived, they found Justin in his room, immersed in playing video games.
Jeremy said the Secret Service agent said to him, "We don't feel he's any danger to the Trumps or anybody right now, but he's a little off."
Justin agreed to go to Bellevue Hospital, where he was voluntarily admitted, says Randy.
How are you feeling about this?
I like it when he's in a hospital for selfish reasons, because I know he's safe.
The whole thing with Ivanka Trump and Lenora Claire?
Justin, not seen as a threat at that time, was released from Bellevue shortly after. The question was, where would he go from there? Committing mentally ill patients against their will for more than 72 hours is extremely difficult, often requiring a legal hearing.
What we need are better resources for those mentally ill people, the seriously mentally ill people that are in our communities, so they can get an adequate level of care and not be allowed to get too far out there with their ideas.
Lenora, whose father was a psychiatrist, understands that Justin's behavior is a result of mental illness.
If I could send a message to Justin, I'd want him to know that I do know that he's a person, you know, and that I do believe that people who are mentally unwell can get help.
Guys, this is Jesus Christ. And a lot of people ask me,
what he's done to me and others is just absolutely awful.
Even Randy admits she can't say for sure what her son might do.
You know, I can't come up here and say, oh, these women are all crazy and he wouldn't hurt them. Because I don't think he would, but he might. I don't know what's in his head.
Justin is now living on his own near his mom in Nevada. Randy says that at this time he's getting his medication on an outpatient basis and is doing well. He has not contacted Lenora for 4 months.
I don't see my stalker ever leaving me alone.
Polly doesn't think she'll ever get relief.
I think I'll have to live like this for the rest of my life.
The physical act of just opening my computer, I've cried.
But Polly vows to continue fighting, determined to change the way we police, prosecute, and even define the crime of stalking.
Many stalking victims are sued by their stalker, frivolous lawsuit, over and over and over again, simply for the fact that they want to be able to see them.
Polly and the others also want ankle monitors for stalkers with restraining orders, a national stalking registry, and stronger internet stalking laws.
If your stalker isn't getting the attention from you that he or she wants, then part of their agenda is going to be to try to destroy you, destroy your reputation, get you fired from your job, break up your relationships.
Polly is now working closely with the Hollywood Police Department and wants other departments to also recognize the problem.
This is happening. There are people out there who are obsessed, and they will not stop. It's real. Stalking is very real.
Ignoring a stalker can be dangerous.
Chris Mahandi says you should avoid all contact, enhance security, and inform key people in your life. Stalking is a crime and should be treated that way.
Early intervention is key. Document, you know, voicemails, letters, cards, take photographs of things that are damaged, and quickly get that information to law enforcement so that they can begin to intervene in the process.
When Christina Grimmie took the stage that night in Orlando, no one ever dreamed a law could be part of her legacy. But that's what her friend Bria Kelly is fighting for.
It didn't have to happen at all. And it's infuriating.
She's proposing Christina's law. She wants to see metal detectors and armed security to protect performers at smaller venues like Plaza Live.
They might still try to harm the performer in some way, but at least it wouldn't be with a bullet.
Just imagine if that law had been in place. Christina's stalker might never have gotten through the door with a gun. And that young woman with so much promise, so much life in front of her, would still be here to live it.
Christina Grimmie's new single, Invisible, was just released by her family, ZXL Music and Republic Records. Proceeds will endow a memorial fund in her name. Learn more about stalking, what you can do to prevent it, and what you can do if you're being stalked. Go to 48hours.com. Hear Tyler Ward sing A Song for Christina, now at 48hours.com.
Lifelong journey. The summer of 1990, I just finished the second grade. That night, I read until I fell asleep. The next thing I remember was waking up in the arms of a man that I didn't know. He was running with me, carrying me down the sidewalk. Then he held a knife to my throat. "You did this to me." And then he choked me as hard as he could. I woke up to him dragging me by my ankles. The scars that I have represent survival. 8 years old, I was just left to die in a field.